Hello students, welcome to the history class of Arvind Academy. In today's class, we are studying about Mahajanapadas. Maha means greater, Janapadas means kingdoms. So we are studying about larger kingdoms that evolved in our ancient history. So these kingdoms for the first time evolved in Indian history in 6th century BCE. So many factors contributed for the emergence of larger kingdoms in 6th century BCE. First, let us see the chronology and we will understand at what point of time these Mahajanapadas come in our history. So if we take Indus Valley civilization flourished during 2500 BC. So the Indus Valley civilization declined after 1750. By 1500 BC, a completely new civilization started, that is Vedic civilization. Again, Vedic civilization also divided into mainly two parts. From 1500 BC to 1000 BC was the early Vedic period, and from 1000 to 600 was the later Vedic period. So from 600 BC onwards, Mahajanapada period starts. So here, this is the Mahajanapada period. So this is early Vedic period. This is later Vedic period. And here, Indus Valley civilization. Before Indus Valley civilization, we have seen it is about Stone Age. And Stone Age does not end with 2500 BC, it continues till 1000 BC. So here broad timeline, here we have seen where Mahajanapada period starts, and it is also the period of Buddha, because one of the great religions of the world, Buddhism, also has its origin in this period. So Mahajanapadas, in the examination point of view also, Mahajanapadas is an important topic, and majorly questions are asked from the capitals of these kingdoms. Suppose Magadha is a Mahajanapada. Question can be asked on the capital of Magadha Mahajanapada, that is Rajagriha. Magadha is also having another capital called Pataliputra. So question can be asked, who laid the foundations for Pataliputra? So such kind of questions can be asked from Mahajanapadas. Let us see the map. This is the map of Mahajanapadas. If you see here, most of the Mahajanapadas are located above Vindhyan range. So if you take Vindhya as the baseline, Vindhyan region. Above Vindhyas, north of Vindhyas, most of these Janapadas are located. And below Vindhyas, one Mahajanapada, that is Ashmaka. Ashmaka is near Python, and in the same place where Satavahana Empire is going to emerge after some time period. So here Vindhyas is the baseline, and above Vindhyas, most of these Janapadas are located. Now we see what are the causes for emergence of Mahajanapadas. Causes are factors which favored for the emergence of these towns and subsequently to the larger kingdoms. So first one, let us take the Indian map. Here, in early Vedic period, this was the zone of settlement. Here, what was the main economic activity? Pastoralism. This is around 1500 BC. And it was nearly, they gradually, up to Yamuna River, they were having settlements. After 1000 BC, they moved to the Ganga Valley. They settled in Ganga Valley. So by 600 BC, they developed a different economic setup like agriculture, trade, for making trade. They created coins also. Those coins were called Panchamarkad coins. These Panchamarkad coins appear in the later, around 600 BC, in the after end of the later Vedic period. So this kind of economic activities flourished after 1000 BC. Because of these factors, new towns emerged. These towns have created more economic growth in the region. So they became economic growth engines. They became growth engines, and they brought more taxation. With this taxation, the rulers created forts. Around the forts, capital cities, new settlements were developed, and these settlements, they became capital towns. So based on this capital town, these larger kingdoms emerged. Small kingdoms were annexed by larger neighbors, powerful neighbors. Because of these factors, some regions must have become powerful wherever agriculture and trade activities are more, and some kingdoms must have been small in power. They were less in power, so they were annexed by larger neighbors. Finally, 16 kingdoms emerged. So these 16 kingdoms have become Mahajanapadas by 600 BCE. So these are various causes. These are various causes for emergence of Mahajanapadas in 600 BCE. So the roots of developments were there in later Vedic period, and after later Vedic period, the small kingdoms or tribal societies emerged into towns. And most importantly, this was also called second urbanization. Second urbanization, because what was the first urbanization? Around Indus Valley civilization, it was the first urbanization that developed around 2500 BC. Let's take Mahajanapadas one by one. We will understand what kind of Mahajanapadas are very important, very powerful, and what are the capital cities of these important Mahajanapadas. So let's take one by one, 16 Mahajanapadas, and let's start with the eastern side. In the easternmost part, here we'll call it as Anga. This was the easternmost Mahajanapada. Capital was Champa. It is located on the river Champa. So these river names and capital names are important. So Anga, Champa. We will understand and we will remember here some of the important Mahajanapadas only. Even though we do not remember all 16 Mahajanapadas and their capitals, at least for important Mahajanapadas and their capitals are required to be noted. This is the easternmost. In Mahabharata story, Karna was mentioned as the king of Anga. This is to remember that Anga is the easternmost part, Champa is the capital of this. Next, immediately left to that is Magadha. Magadha was the most powerful Mahajanapada when comparing with all other neighbors. It is very important and it requires a special focus. We will understand about Magadha in a separate sheet. We need not to worry about the details of Magadha here. For now, you just remember the capital city of Magadha was Rajgir. So Rajgir was the Magadha capital. Next, another one is the neighbor is Vaishali or Vajji Confederacy. It was a Republican Mahajanapada. These Magadha and Anga were monarchies. Monarchies means single rule, single person rule the kingdom, and whatever he says, that is the law of the land. Whereas in Vajji, many kings came together and formed a confederacy. They take decision based on discussions and debates. So that's why Vajji was a confederacy. It has eight major clans. This Vajji is important because in this confederacy Vardhamana Mahavira was born. So we have to remember. So the importance of Mahajanapada comes when there is any other historical development also taken place. So here Vajji means, we have to remember Vardhamana Mahavira. So that's why Vajji is important one. Here the capital city is Vaishali. Now this fourth one is Malla, neighboring state. This is another Mahajanapada. The capital city is Kushinagara. Kushinagara is important because Buddha died in this place. Buddha died in Kushinagara. That's why Malla Mahajanapada and Kushinagara and its capital Kushinagara are important. Next, another one is Kosala. Kosala was the story of Ramayana. In Ramayana, Lord Ram belongs to this Kosala Mahajanapada. And here, this is the Mahajanapada in which Ayodhya, the city Ayodhya, is located. But Ayodhya was not the capital of Kosala. The Kosala capital was Shravasti. Kosala is also important because Buddha has given more number of sermons in Kosala only. That's why Buddha was also called Kosalan. This Buddha was also called Kosalan. He, the Buddha who belongs to Kosala. So that is the importance of Kosala. Next, another neighbor was Kashi. So come here, Kashi. Kashi is Mahajanapada in which Varanasi is located. Varanasi is the capital city of Kashi Mahajanapada. And Varanasi is important because this is the place where Buddha has given first sermon, Saranad. Saranad is located near Varanasi. Buddha has given first sermon after enlightenment. So because of Mahavira's association and Buddha's association, these Mahajanapadas have gained prominence. That's why these are very important for examination perspective as well. So in examination, they can ask the capital cities of these any of these important Mahajanapadas. And when it comes to Magadha, the Magadhan imperialism occupies significant place in history. And we study about Magadhan imperialism. Imperialism means expansionary policies of Magadha. You can see Magadha was a very small Mahajanapada comparing with the later territory of Magadha. This small kingdom is going to expand throughout the subcontinent till northwestern part of India, western part and deep south and eastern part. By the time it reaches Ashoka, almost entire subcontinent is under Magadhan rule. So that's why Magadha is an important Mahajanapada. We have to remember the first capital. Magadha has two capitals. One is Rajgir, another one is Pataliputra. Here one is Rajgir, second one is Pataliputra. This we will study later. Hence, therefore, up to six Mahajanapadas we have seen here. Now let us see the seventh one, the neighboring one, the capital city of this is Vascha. महाजनपद. द कैपिटल सिटी इज कौशाम्बी. कौशाम्बी इज इंपॉर्टेंट. लेट अस स्टडी अलॉन्ग विद दिस एइथ वन अवंती. अवंती इज अनदर महाजनपद इन सेंट्रल पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया. इट ऑल्सो हैज टू कैपिटल्स लाइक मगध. वन इज उज्जैन, अनदर वन इज महिष्मति. Mahishmati is the southern capital, Ujjaini is the northern capital. So the below Vindhyas is Mahishmati, above Vindhyas located Ujjain. So Avanti is important. Now combinedly if we study Avanti and Vastha, these two Mahajanapadas occupies a significant place in history. A writer called Bhasa, who wrote Swapna Vasyavadatta, Swapna Vasyavadatta. This is important. Who wrote Swapna Vasyavadatta? The writer was Bhasa. He was one of the great writers, Sanskrit writers of our ancient India. His importance or his greatness we can see by mentioning Kalidasa. Because Kalidasa came after Bhasa, but Kalidasa says Bhasa was a greater personality in Sanskrit literature. So Kalidasa used to invoke Bhasa often in his literature. So that means if Kalidasa is giving credit to a person, means he should have been a great writer. So Bhasa has written Swapna Vasyavadatta. In this writing, in this novel, these two stories will come, Avanti and Vastha. Vastha prince and Avanti princess. The love affair between Avanti princess and Vastha prince is the crux of Swapna Vasyavadatta. So here you can remember Bhasa, Swapna Vasyavadatta, and Vastha Kaushambi, Avanti Ujjain, and Mahishmati. So combinedly you can understand the importance of these two Mahajanapadas. Not only Bhasa, even Harsha also, Harshavardhana, he himself was a writer. He also has written two important novels. Those two important novels also contains the story of the love story between Vastha prince and Avanti princess. So these two, so Harsha also invokes these two Mahajanapadas. Hence these two are important. Now come to the left, the western part of these two Mahajanapadas. Here we will see 9, 10, 11, 12. Here 9th one was Kuru, 10th one is Panchala, 11th one is Saurasheni, 12th one is Matsya. These four Mahajanapadas we study in combination. We can remember these four Mahajanapadas in combination because these four Mahajanapadas were the major centers in Mahabharata story. In Mahabharata story, Kuru Mahajanapada is the place where Pandavas and Kauravas are based. Panchala is the kingdom of Draupadi's father. And Saurasheni is the, you can see here, Kuru, Panchala, Matsya, Saurasena. So this is the region. In this region, so Saurasena, Madura is the prominent place in this. Madura means we remember Lord Sri Krishna. So in Mahabharata, Kurukshetra war happened in Kuru kingdom. So Panchala, Kuru, Saurasheni, the Madura region. So which is important for Sri Krishna, Vasudeva. And Matsya is Viratnagar, is located in Matsya kingdom. So these four kingdoms were very important places in Mahabharata story, where the Mahabharata story revolves. Hence these Mahajanapadas we have to remember in a sequence way so that you will remember it. Now already 12 Mahajanapadas came. Now another one. Here you can see Ashmaka. it is the only Mahajanapada which is located below Vindhyan range. So around this Ashmaka Mahajanapada, Shatavahana Empire will emerge in future period. So this is 13th one. Now let's come to here. Is there any other one? Chedi is the one important another one. This in Bundelkhand region. In Bundelkhand region, there is a Mahajanapada called Chedi. And this also you can combine here. So if you take this as 14th one, you take this one as 13th Chedi. Here in Mahabharata, Shishupala Vada, where Lord Sri Krishna kills Shishupala, the story Shishupala, Shishupala was, he belongs to Chedi Mahajanapada. So you can remember based on Mahabharata these five Mahajanapadas together. And once this is done, 14th one is Ashmaka. Now the 15th and 16th come here. Here these two are two important Mahajanapadas in the western part. One is Gandhara and another one is Kamboja. These two are the westernmost parts in Mahajanapada list. Here important center is Takshila. Takshila is important in terms of its educational center. Takshila is important because it is having the oldest university in India. This university is very important university where Kautilya also studied. Many other prominent people studied in Takshila University. So these are 16 Mahajanapadas and some important capitals we have seen, and you can see the importance of some of these capitals because they occupied significance because Mahavira and Buddha associated with some of these Mahajanapadas. Buddha was born here in Kapilavastu kingdom. It is just above Kosala. So Kosala we have seen Ayodhya, just above Kosala, Kapilavastu there. In Kapilavastu, it is also a republican like Vajji Confederacy and Malla Republic. This Vajji and Malla are republics. Vajji Republic, Malla also Republic, and another one is in between Kosala and Malla was Kapilavastu. The capital city of Kapilavastu was Lumbini. Lumbini is now present in Nepal. So where Buddha was born. So these are various capital cities of Mahajanapadas, and you can remember some of these Mahajanapadas and some of the writers like Bhasa Swapna Vashyavadatta, which is based on Vascha and Avanti kingdom. Kalidasa also praised Bhasa. Harsha also has written about the love story between Avanti princess and Vascha king in his writings as well. In his writings like Ratnavali. So Ratnavali. So this is about Mahajanapadas and their capitals.